The ideas of Batman and Gotham City are forever intertwined. For Bruce Wayne, Gotham's crime and corruption are what led to his creation through the murders of his parents, as well as what forever drives his war as Batman. For Gotham, Batman is an icon of hope, battling those that would take advantage of the innocent and inspiring its people to embrace something better. While that cycle may be one of courage and heroism, there is a darker side to it as well. One of voracious darkness that consumes those that try and wage war against it. It's that abyss within Gotham that writer Scott Snyder and artists Jock and Francesco Francavilla dove into with their comic book storyline Batman the Black Mirror, which was originally published in the pages of Detective Comics number 871 through 881 in 2011. Its dark twists and unrelenting gothic nature make it one of the essential stories for Batman fans in the modern era. Set during a time in DC Comics where Dick Grayson, also known as Nightwing, the former Robin, has taken on the identity of Batman in Gotham City while Bruce Wayne operates as Batman elsewhere in the world, The Black Mirror focuses on the toll that Gotham City itself takes on Grayson, as well as Police Commissioner Jim Gordon. Using a dueling narrative, The Black Mirror switches back and forth between the two men, as Grayson fights against several new criminal operations that redefine crime in Gotham, while Gordon deals with the return of his son James, a man in his early 20s who may be a violent psychopath. As their stories become more and more intertwined, they must reconcile themselves with the inability to ever completely understand Gotham and the almost living darkness that the city breeds within its people. During its original publication, the 11-issue run began with the stories of Batman and Gordon being typically told in the same issue, with Batman's story taking up the majority of the pages and Gordon's being told in a backup. With both stories happening at the same time chronologically, Snyder was able to interweave them and juxtapose their ideas. Jock's scratchy dark art was used for Batman's story, with his sharp angles and heavy shadows being perfect for stories that took place in the darkest and cruelest parts of Gotham. His use of sketchy lines and creases in his portrayal of characters helps to convey the toll that Gotham is taking on everyone, especially the typically exuberant Grayson. Meanwhile, Francavilla's much more lush and smooth artwork was dedicated to Gordon's story, which heavily focuses on the interpersonal dynamic between Commissioner Gordon, his quietly menacing son James, and his daughter Barbara, the former Batgirl. A heavy use of deep oranges, reds, and blues emphasize the noir feel of the story, and Francavilla's detailed portrayals of emotion keep every little line of dialogue, every minor expression, crucial to uncovering the mystery at the center of Gordon's story. And when the two stories collide in The Black Mirror's final chapter, Jock and Francavilla's art switches back and forth to illustrate their unique yet interconnected aspects of the climax. It's these simple yet strongly executed ideas that help to keep The Black Mirror so thematically resonant. The ideas of hunger and being consumed permeate much of the story, as moments like a victim being eaten alive by a killer whale, Batman being nearly crushed in a junkyard compactor, a rat devouring a bird's eggs, and numerous victims either being dismembered or threatened with dismemberment all occurring throughout the narrative. Gotham is a hungry city, and so are the residents who give in to its darkness. Grayson opens the story of the Black Mirror by reflecting on his time in the circus, traveling as an acrobat with his parents. Their map was marked with pins on each of the cities they planned to visit, each signaling how dangerous their stunts would be when they performed there. But Gotham alone had a black pin, meaning that all the stops needed to be pulled, and the most dangerous maneuvers were necessary. Why? "Some places just have a hunger about them, son," Grayson's father told him, "and you either feed them what they want, or you stay far, far away." It's clear that Gotham feeds off the weak, and that many of its worst citizens feed off them too. Some leave to escape its darkness, some are altered by it, some are strengthened, and some, like Bruce Wayne, stand fast against it and seek to reshape it to their will. However, Grayson isn't like Bruce Wayne. It's clear to Grayson himself and the people that understand him that he isn't driven in the same compulsive, unhealthy manner that Wayne is in the way he fights for Gotham, because Grayson wasn't fundamentally altered in the way that Wayne was at an early age. For Wayne, being Batman and fighting crime is a compulsion. For Grayson, it is a choice. Grayson is far more optimistic, far more willing to see the good in people and hope for something better. While he's still prepared for the worst and trained to do his best, he's vulnerable to the darkest aspects of Gotham, which he faces in the new breed of criminal working to exploit the city for all it's worth, and in the form of James Gordon Jr. While villains like the Dealer and Tiger Shark are defined by voracious appetites that reflect the ever-hungry nature of Gotham, it is the sociopathic nature of James that makes him the opposite of Grayson to a large degree. Through the use of Grayson as its lead character, readers are given a far more vulnerable and less predictable protagonist. This is a Batman who smiles and believes in the goodness of people, but one who is burdened by the role he must assume to protect his city. Make no mistake, Grayson is a great hero, but he lacks the seeming invulnerability that Bruce Wayne is often given by writers. While Batman must choose to either succumb to Gotham or be strengthened by its challenges, it is clear that James was changed by it at an early age. The cause of James' sociopathy is unclear. It may be genetic. It may have been caused by a fall at an early age, heavily hinted to be the climax of Batman Year One. But the themes of the Black Mirror tell us that it was Gotham itself that altered James. Not in a literal, supernatural way, but in the way that a city so dark and voracious ultimately changes so many of its people. Even Gordon himself questions the nature of Gotham. That unknowable factor means that Jim Gordon is forever haunted by his son's issues. While young James was featured in Frank Miller's Batman Year One, the character disappeared from comics afterward. In The Black Mirror, Snyder retroactively clarifies that James was a disturbed child from an early age, showing signs of sociopathy and violent tendencies that worried his parents. But while no proof could ever be found to show that James was indeed violent and even possibly homicidal, his father was haunted by the possibility. When they divorced, Jim's ex-wife took her son with her, and James Jr. eventually left to explore the country as a young adult. His return to Gotham brings countless questions into Gordon's life, and much of The Black Mirror leaves the questions of James Jr.'s sociopathic nature unanswered, leaving Gordon and readers both confounded and haunted. Like Jim, Barbara is equally disturbed by her brother, with a past tragedy in their childhood years being slowly revealed to the readers. Its implications are horrifying, and Snyder displays a real mastery at unveiling the truth at the right pace. After several issues of questioning James Jr.'s motives, the answers hit readers in an unexpected and gruesome moment of pure terror that reflects Snyder's roots as a horror writer. The reveal of James Jr.'s true nature shifts the mystery into dramatic irony, as readers now know the truth about the character while its protagonists are still left in doubt. This creates a horrifying collision course for Batman, Jim, and Barbara that will threaten their own beliefs about human nature. By asking questions of its readers that have no hard and clear answers, Snyder probes deeper into the nature of Batman and Gordon, as well as Gotham City itself. Like any classic Batman story, massive action sequences and dark mysteries bring these haunting ideas to life, but their disturbing and unanswerable nature lingers with the reader. Despite the many battles both won and lost, Gotham remains an unknowable, constantly changing landscape that challenges the minds and souls of those who try to understand and better it. Snyder leaves his readers with a sense of unease, knowing that Gotham will forever attempt to consume its citizens so long as it stands, but also knowing that good people will always be there to fight the darkness. It's up to each person to decide whether they will be strengthened by Gotham City or consumed by it, in one way or another.